Om Shri Sai Ram. Welcome my dear friends to a new episode of Inspiring Classrooms. Being inspired is one thing, but doing is something else. So, let us today take the first step to be self-reliant. And from where do we learn this message of being self-reliant? Not from any big thing, but from a small plant which doesn't depend on anybody but on itself for living, for sustenance and for its own food. So, let us step into a biology classroom and know more about this process. Let us interact with Mrs. Prabhavati ma'am.
Before that, let us have a glimpse of this wonderful series that is going to begin from mid-May. So, my dear friends, get set.
You joined recently, but I know you worked some years back also, no?
2007 I worked here, ma'am. Started my journey here.
And you took a break in the middle.
Yes, ma'am.
Incidentally, Afroz was your student, no?
Yes,
the person who's behind the camera now was your student.
Yes, ma'am.
And it's really a proud moment for all of us, right? As a biology teacher, there are two branches here. Of course, zoology is there and botany is also there. But already we have got an episode of zoology, okay? Vijayalakshmi ma'am spoke about it. So today, can you tell something about plants and something that all children can understand? Any concept is there in biology which you
yes,
can see?
Ma'am. We can take photosynthesis.
Photosynthesis, yeah, I have an idea. Can you tell in two words, like simple way, what photosynthesis is?
Yes, ma'am. As our mom cooks for us, so what else she will use? So you use many ingredients in that. But here, the plants prepare its own food with only few ingredients like sunlight, carbon dioxide and water.
Wow, that's very nice way of putting it, but I would like to hear more from you. Can I explain?
Yeah, sure ma'am.
Plants prepare their food on their own by the process called photosynthesis. Photo means light, synthesis means putting together. Have you ever wondered how plants grow and prepare their food? To cook food, we need ingredients like oil, water, vegetables, salt, spices, etc. But plants need only few ingredients like sunlight, water, carbon dioxide and chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is a substance which is present in all green plants, especially in leaves. So, the leaves are called kitchen of the plant. The root absorbs the water from the soil and carbon dioxide from the air. Plants breathe in carbon dioxide and breathe out oxygen through the minute opening called stomata. So, the plants are the major source of oxygen on earth and keep us alive. Plants capture sunlight using the pigment chlorophyll. Now, the process of taking these key ingredients and making them into food is called photosynthesis. Oxygen and food are produced during photosynthesis. Excess food are stored in fruits, vegetables and roots. This is why we are able to eat carrots, potatoes, apples, watermelons and other vegetables and fruits. Oxygen that is produced during photosynthesis is released into the atmosphere. This oxygen is what we breathe and we cannot live without it. So, photosynthesis is so essential to life on Earth that most living organisms, including humans, cannot survive without it.
Prabhavati ma'am, your explanation of the photosynthesis concept was very clear. I'm sure even the primary kids would have understood what you said. But yeah, I'm very interested to know what value you can tell. But yeah, in a science classroom, we can't take so much time and explain a value. Try to tell it in two sentences.
Yeah, sure ma'am. Plants do so much good things to us. Let us also be selfless like them.
Yeah, that's very nice. Being selfless is one thing that we can learn from nature. Trees bear fruit not for themselves but for us. The river flows incessantly not because it has some thirst but to quench the thirst of mankind. Every creation of God is selfless. It is oozing with the love of God. So let us take this message from nature. And very rightly you have pointed out that beautiful message. So my dear friends, this is not all. I'm sure most of you can talk of numerous values when it comes to this particular topic. I would request all of you to ponder over it and also, if possible, put it in the comments as to which value you can relate to the topic of photosynthesis. Okay, my dear friends. Also remember to subscribe to the channel and press the bell button for notification. Stay tuned. Thank you. Jai Sai.